morning, Xavier. This is this week's hidden object game. The hidden object this week is this candle. If you can identify this candle three times or more, you can put your name into a bucket at lunch after Hawk News. The winner will be drawn, and you will win $10 to Quick Trip. Good luck.
I love living in Appleton. It's so exciting. Everywhere you turn, there's just something you can do. Like, you can pick up Latin. You can go bowling, curling.
Well, we used to go to Club Trespass a lot, but that closed down.
I like to go to the building for kids. I like the mall.
I really hate Appleton, so.
I told this to the students this year that you would think going 15 times, this was my 15th trip, that it would get old and you wouldn't want to keep going back. But every time I go, I get to see the country through their eyes. That's what's really neat, is I really think that the trip changes people's lives for the better. Bucket baths, most of them have outdoor plumbing, so they have to go to an outhouse, and it's just very different for them. They have mosquito nets that they have to put around their beds when they sleep at night.
Some ways they remain the same, and as my mind begins to spread its wings, there's no stopping curiosity. I wanna turn the whole thing upside down. I'll find the things they say just can't be found. I'll share this love I find with everyone.
My favorite part was climbing the mountain.
Mine was playing on the playground with little kids.
Going up into the compos, which is the villages in the mountains, and having mass with all the people up there.
To all the people in the town, because they're really welcoming and hospitable to all of us, and they put up with our poor Spanish speaking skills.
Hello, Xavier. I'm here with Libby, Emily, and John, talking about the huge problem that is going on in the Xavier parking lot. Jay Money, what do you feel there is something to resolve this?
You know, it's been really tough. I've had to set my alarm for 3:30 every single morning. I have to leave here by 4:30 every single morning, and I still usually don't get a spot. I've had to walk miles away. I've started to camp out here, hoping to get a spot. This has really been tough on me and my family. So, it's not a good thing, and I wouldn't wish it upon anyone.
It was you.
Hello, I'm here with Brian today, and do you think that underclassmen should park in the street?
I think they should park in the parking lot that those students that would drive, because I think that all students who drive deserve equal rights for all, and there's a lot of space in the parking lot.
Thank you, Brian.
Xavier, you know, this has been a huge problem for 2 or 3 years now. can't stand this. Whoever's car this is, Libby Funk, I think. You know, pretty sure we interviewed you and you said that we were gonna fix this problem. By the looks of it, you're not helping at all. I don't know what to do.
Yep. Going to school, Xavier's parking lot, usually a nightmare. I don't know. People park sideways, park in handicapped spots. Spots you're not supposed to be in. You know, that's just not cool. It's not that hard to find a parking spot and park in it like a normal human being instead of like a, you know, not human being.
J-Man, D-Man, and Jake, and we're part of
Paranormal Investigators. Xavier High School hired us, a four-man team, to come in to decide whether or not Xavier High School has a ghost. Through interviews and personal experience, we will decide for ourselves whether or not Xavier High School has a ghost. You guys ready?
Yeah.
All right, let's go.
It's very possible that there is a ghost lurking in the Xavier hallway. A little known fact is that several years ago, there actually was a killing here. Where the spirit of that burglar is, we'll never know.
Our attention that you have a story about Xavier's ghost.
Yeah, one day I was just walking by the basement doors here, and some man just wearing bloody clothes just walked into the doors and I wanted to try and follow him downstairs, but the doors were locked and I couldn't do anything.
He didn't have any keys?
No, nothing. He just walked right through.
That's crazy. Our investigation next will lead us into Xavier's basement. My name is Derek Vinlith. I'm here, I'm part of Paranormal Activities Investigation, and I'm here with Jared and Andy, and we're about to investigate Andrew Farr's story of the Bloody Man. Are you guys ready?
No. Let's do this.
It's really scary.
Thanks for mentioning me.
Now we tried to turn on the lights earlier and they didn't work, so this is our first time going down and we don't know what's going on. Oh my gosh. We didn't
pull it.
Oh my gosh.
Jared, you go first.
Shut up, Andy.
As you can see, the one light that does work is the emergency exit. And I think that's a sign from the ghost saying, leave and don't come down here.
You said, no, don't touch it.
This room over here.
Turn the light on! Ah! Turn the light on!
After our first two trips down to the basement and realizing it really is haunted, we went onto the App Store and we read some reviews and Ghost Radar. We're going to be using. As you can see, we have a readout here on the bottom. The bleep line is going to let us know if there's a ghost, and then a blue dot will come up. So we're going to head on down.
If I see one dot on that thing, I'm out.
Man out.
Oh.
Oh.
Are you kidding?
I have some detection here.
There's a little bit of detection.
It's a little bit of detection here at the bottom. Do you see that bleep? There's a ghost in the back room where we were earlier with the lights. I swear, there's a ghost.
We gotta keep going.
Oh my gosh, it just got red. Now it's gone. It's gone now. It's gone.
Oh my god.
I don't
like this.
This is killing me mentally. I
Can't handle my gosh, over there.
Oh my god!
Turn the one over there.
Turn the light, turn the light.
Do you see that yellow bleep? It's the yellow bleep right there.
It's not funny. The PVC pipe.
Oh my gosh, it's showing two over here. It's showing two over here. Two over here. Ah! Ah! Ah!